Respected juries and all participants, this is Tanisha Rathore presenting topic Eyewitness Testimony in Psychological Investigation. Next slide. Firstly, I want to introduce what is eyewitness testimony. Simply put, an eyewitness is someone who has been a spectator of a dramatic event or a crime scene. The one who can give an account of the event. For example, if I'm walking down the street and I notice a brawl happening between two individuals. There is a crowd gather and I join the crowd. Suddenly it gets ugly and police has to be called. Now, even though I may not know any of these individuals, but I am an eyewitness to the event along with the other gather around. Next slide. Memories play a very important role in the eyewitness testimony, so I want to discuss the role of eyewitness memory in this slide. Eyewitness recall often plays an important role in investigation of crime. When a crime occurs, police officer responding to the crime interview the eyewitness regarding their memories associated with the crime. The interview may be interviewed numerous times throughout the investigation. Some of the details recalled by the eyewitness, such as description of weapon or a clothing worn by perpetrator. Research on eyewitness recall has examination various type of a factor that affects accuracy of eyewitness description, such as level of stress, anxiety, leading question, etc. Next slide. Factors that affect the accuracy of the eyewitness testimony: stress, anxiety, weapon focus, leading question. High proportion of experts agreed that the very high level of stress impaired the accuracy of the eyewitness. The eyewitness literature often claims that emotional stress led to an impairment in memory and hence that details of unpleasant emotional events are remembered less accurately than details of a neutral or average events. A common assumption behind this view is that a decrease in available processing capacity occurs at a state of a high emotional arousal, which therefore lead to the less efficient memory processes. There is a Yerkes and Dodson law, which showed according to that law, increasing with the performance, increasing with the physiological or mental state, but only up to a point when the level of a stress becomes to the high performance decreases. Next slide. Anxiety. Witnessing a crime can be a stressful experience in some cases. The anxiety people experience as a result of such events may alter their perceptions of whom or what they saw. This may lead to inaccurate identification or testimony. Next slide, ma'am. Leading question. Witness questioning is related to the information that is given to a witness after they experience the event and the way in which the witness are questioned about the event. It has been repeatedly demonstrated that the wordings and intonation of a question can lead a witness to provide incorrect information. For example, participant witness were asked either, did you see a broken headlight or did you see the broken headlight? Even though only one word is different between the two conditions, participants who heard the word the rather than the word a were more likely to indicate that they had seen a broken headlight. Slide. Weapon focus. In many crimes involving a weapon, witness report difficulties remembering the face of a perpetrator. Weapon during the commission of a crime often compacts this issue because witness may focus on the weapon rather than the suspect or other details. Improving the accuracy of the eyewitness. There is one method known as cognitive interview, which can improve the accuracy of the eyewitness testimony. The cognitive interview was developed by the Fisher and Gieselman 1992 as a series of a memory retrieval and communication techniques to improve recall in police interview. The cognitive interview is based primarily on two factors. Fielding's idea that there are several retrieval paths to each memory and information not available through one pathway may be accessible through another. Second, the encoding specificity of a principle. The idea that memory traces rely upon as many retrieval cues as possible and that memory can be improved. If an individual recalls the information in similar context, instead to the original encoding. थैंक यू।